Let's see here. Let's see if I can turn this on. I'm gonna run out of light here. Ooh, there we go. We got the LEDs going, people. Do you guys need some last minute Christmas ideas? You probably don't, but I'm gonna, you know what, people? This is just an excuse for me to open up some Hot Wheels and look at some comic books on camera. I was at the Walmart the other day, people, and I picked up this set right here. It's a set of five. Check that out. We've got five Venomized cars, okay? We got the Spider-Man, Maximum Venom, obviously Groot. Look at him right there. And he's got, what does he have there? Groot has a custom 2015 Ford Mustang. That's really cool. And we've got all these other ones here. These are in no particular order. This is a numbered set. This is 2 out of 5. This is Iron Man, Spider-Man, Doctor Strange. Look at that Venomized Doctor Strange. I gotta admit, people, I'm not really a big Doctor Strange fan. But you know what? That's neither here nor there, everybody. And check this out. We got the El Camino right here. The 1971 El Camino Venomized Captain America. I can tell you right now, this is my favorite car right here. All of these cars, all of them were like $1.25 at Walmart, and they would make a perfect stocking stuffer, everybody. Look at that, Venomized Spider-Man. And this right here, this got me thinking. You know, when I start thinking, oh my goodness, when I start thinking, things get a little bit dangerous, you could say. And I got to thinking, and you know what? I was thinking about comic books at the same time, obviously because this is Spider-Man Venom related. You know what? I'm just gonna open this up while I'm talking. And I was thinking about comic books, people, and I was thinking about Venom. Ooh, that's a cool car. Iron Man's car right here, this is called the Jackhammer. I was thinking about comic books, people, and I picked up these not too long ago. This is the Savage Avengers. I got the first four, no, how many did I get? The first four or five issues. I'm not really too sure exactly how many I got. I think I got five, but one of them is a variant cover. You know how they like to do variant covers? But you got the Savage Avengers here, people. Venom right here, obviously. So this is what got me thinking about it, the Maximum Venom. We got the Venom here. You know what? I'm gonna open this car right now, too. This is the Spider-Man right here. Open that up. This is a 1970 Dodge Hemi Challenger. Check it out. Pretty cool symbol on the side. I like that car. Ooh, I like this spider right here. But you got the Savage Avengers here, people. Who wouldn't like the Savage Avengers in their stocking for Christmas? Check this out. You got Venom and you got this guy right here. This is Dr. Voodoo. I'm not really too familiar with that character. You got Conan here, the Punisher, Elektra, and everyone's favorite good old Wolverine right there. And this thing is just chocked full of mindless violence. Look at this. Anybody interested in science fiction or fantasy or anything like that, I mean, look, you got Conan fighting ninjas, and then Wolverine shows up and cuts his face, and they have a huge fight that goes on for, I don't even know, like 5 or 6 pages. And I mean, look at this. You've got all this blood magic. They're summoning all these weird creatures. I mean, who would not want something like this? Now, I don't know if you can actually get Savage Avengers right now, because you know, people, it is Christmas Eve. But you know what? If you nip to your nearest Walmart, there are comic books there. And you know what? Comic books, they don't have to be about superheroes, people. Let's get that out of the way. I also picked this up right here. Check this out. This is the Hot Wheels Super Rigs. Look at that, people. The Haulin' Horsepower. Check that out. You know what? I am going to open this up right now. Okay, this is not going. Oh my goodness. Well, that didn't work out very well. Having a lot of trouble getting it. There we go. Just gonna say I had trouble getting into this, but look at this. Now, I wouldn't mind one of these in real life. And you get this big rig right here. Does this detach? It must detach. Oh, actually, you know what? I don't think it does detach. Oh, I'm gonna break it. No, I don't think it detaches. I thought it did. So your car can just ride right up in there like that. Check it out. It's even got like little grooves for the back wheels right there. Oh, that didn't work. There we go. Okay, let's put this down. Let's take the El Camino here, the maximum venom, not 2% venom. We're talking maximum here. This is the coolest car right here, I gotta say. Captain America's El Camino, just because I really like El Caminos, people. You don't see El Caminos on the street anymore. It's really unfortunate. If you guys do see an El Camino on the road, take a picture of it, because you might not see another one for a long time. Let's put the El Camino in there. Oh, there, and look, it fits right in there. That is absolutely perfect. Look at Doctor Strange just sitting there. And you know what else this Savage Avengers kind of got me thinking about here? We got Conan right here, everybody. And I started to revisit some of the old Conan novels that I have. And look what I found inside this one right here. I'm not really too sure exactly how to pronounce that, so you guys can just pronounce it however you want. But check it out. You have this classic Frank Frazetta artwork on the front here. And I'm paging through this, people, and check it out. Look what I found. Look right here. I found an old old bookmark from when I was a kid. Skeletor, and this is a Masters of the Universe sticker. These came in like a sticker book. This is number 54, and in the book, you would place this on square number 54. But that's my old bookmark right inside this old Conan book. Now, I wasn't actually reading this one. I actually started reading this one right here, Conan the Avenger. Look at that artwork. That's some more Frank Frazetta artwork right there. I think the original, the woman was naked, and this guy looked quite a bit different. This does not look like Conan in the traditional sense. That's Conan of the Isles. This artwork here always puzzled me, even as a little kid. It's called Conan the Buccaneer. Now, a buccaneer is like a pirate. This is not pirate-inspired artwork, I don't think. It doesn't scream pirate to me. Anyway, everybody, if you want to pick up a book for somebody... Oh, dang it, I just lost my lights. And check it out, maybe I can do this without the lights, with the LEDs going. There we go, everybody, I got my lights fixed. I use this light here, and it runs off of batteries. It's not really ideal, but you know what, I make do with... You know what, that's a lot brighter. I make do with what I've got. And you know what, I'm just gonna unbox this guy right here. Now, what was I saying? I think I was saying something about books, and I can't get into the Doctor Strange. It's probably because I said I didn't like Doctor Strange. It's not that I don't like Doctor Strange. I just, you know, I didn't really read Doctor Strange comic books when I was a kid. This is called the Tail Dragger, and you know what? This is actually a really cool car. Now that I have it out of the box, I don't know. Or the package, whatever. I guess it's a box. This, I don't know. I don't know which one's cooler, the El Camino or the Tail Dragger. I don't know. Let's put the Tail Dragger in there. It's pretty cool. Yeah, I think I was talking about books. If you're gonna get somebody a book, I would suggest a short work of fiction. Because if you get somebody a self-help book, they might take it the wrong way and it might lead to a discussion that you probably don't want to have. Check out Groot's car. I guess I like Groot. I don't really know. I do like that symbol on the side though. Actually, this is a pretty cool car too. I think all of the maximized Venom cars are pretty cool. Put in the comments section which one you think is the coolest. I'm torn between the El Camino and the Tail Dragger, but I think they're all pretty cool. I also picked this up right here, Super Rigs, the Fossil Freight. Check that out. These were a little bit more expensive than the cars. Actually, one of these is more than all of these cars combined, but you know what? It's well worth it. Let's get into this one. Well, that one opened a lot easier. Let's check this out. Let's move this guy out of here. Let's put this down here. Open that up, and there's some weird... What kind of dinosaur is this? Is this a Stegosaurus? I think it's a Stegosaurus. You know, I wanted to be a paleontologist when I was a kid. Look at all these psychedelic patterns on here. You know what else is crazy? I got this one here too. This big monster truck right here. It says, "Will trash it all." And check this out. It opens up in the back so you could, I don't know, put something in there. You could stash, you know, maybe, I don't know, like a handcuff key in there or something. You know, just, you know, thinking outside the box. I think this has a movable jaw. Oh, look at that. The engine's right inside the mouth. Look at that. Back opens up. I think we're gonna put the Groot car in there because I think Groot, yeah, and he needs to be locked up. Check it out here, everybody. We got Sasha Banks. It's boss time. She's just gonna run over all that. If you want to go a little bit more fancy, you can go with something like this. This is a Star Wars set, but this is a little bit more premium. See, this is Boba Fett right here. Again, this is a numbered set, 3 out of 5. And he's got the Ford Transit Supervan. Now, these are, what do they call these? These are metal, or what are they called? Real Riders is what they call them. Now, they're like an all-metal Hot Wheel, so they cost a little bit more, but they're pretty cool. You know what? Let's open up Boba Fett right now. Everybody likes Boba Fett, right? Who's been watching the Mandalorian? Put it in the comment section. I haven't seen a single episode. I'm not gonna lie, that's pretty badass. I like the orange wheels. Very cool. Oh look, it's even got a symbol. I can't remember what that's called. A friggin', I don't even know, Wampa skull or something. I know that's not what it actually is. It'll come to me after the video's done. And these are all like an Imperial theme. Set the trap, defend the Death Star. I don't have a whole lot of Star Wars memorabilia, people, but you know what? I do like a guy. I like Star Wars. Set the trap, defend the Death Star. And check out the artwork on there. It's pretty cool. We got the walker in the back. We got Emperor Palpatine's personal shuttle up here. And of course, everybody wants to be riding around on one of these speeders. And this is a 1985 Chevy Astro van. Gotta open that up. There we go. Look at this. It's got some kind of, I don't even know. I don't know what's going on there. Straight piped out the side. It looks like a speeder. Look, it's even got like a wheelie bar on the back. If you guys want an insanely violent comic, I highly recommend you check out Space Punisher. Buy this comic or I shoot this planet. And you know what? He's not kidding. See, in this Space Punisher, there's also the Space Hulk. And there's these big-headed guys. They're called the Watchers. Well, let me tell you something. Space Hulk, he finishes them off rather brutally. And then look what happens. Space Hulk rips into his chest, pulls out Banner, and Banner asks Punisher to kill him. And look what Punisher does. Without even flinching, just blam. And then Space Hulk gets all mad, but then he just leaves. It's a 4-issue series, highly recommended. This must be Darth Vader's personal van. It's called Dream Van XGW. I don't know what that means. Get into this one. Ooh, that opened up really easily. Check out that van right there. What is this, Morse code? It says Join the Empire on the back. Looks pretty futuristic. I like this one here. Strike back, crush the rebellion. Look at all these walkers here. And we've got a 1988 Mercedes Unimog U1300. If you guys don't know what a Unimog is, check it out on YouTube. There's some pretty cool videos. This one is really hard to get into. There we go. Look at that air intake. You got the walkers down the side of the van. Imperial symbol on the top. And even says, crush the rebellion right on the side. You gotta love it. This one right here, people, this is Savage Avengers number 2. It's still in the bag. Check out Wolverine and Conan going at it there. Savage Avengers number 3. We've got Conan there, and there looks like the symbiote. That's Venom right there. What's going on? Look at the skulls. Who wouldn't want this? Check it out, people. Rebel spotted. Protect the Empire. And look, we got the Millennium Falcon flying up there. And this is the Super Van. Let's get into this. Let me move that van up here. Check that one out, everybody. Very cool artwork on the side. You know, I don't normally like yellow, but I can make an exception here. I want to see if the Unimog will fit in there. I don't think it will, but you know what? We're going to find out. No, it won't. Oh, well, they can kind of cage it in there. Kind of. You know, we put some bungee straps down here or something. You know how we do it. You know, I didn't even notice there's like a dragon on the side of the trailer there. Very cool. All right, people. Well, that's just some of my recommendations. If you guys are looking for quick, very easy Christmas presents, stocking stuffers, that sort of thing, look no further than Hot Wheels, some good old comic books. Here's Savage Avengers number 4, and Conan, he's got that AR-15. There's those ninjas he was fighting in the original one. They're the Punisher. He's got the sword. You gotta love it. How am I gonna stack all this up? Anyway, we got Avengers, we got Savage Avengers, people. I mean, Wolverine and Wolverine and Conan are fighting. Come on. Really cool toy hauler type things. Stegosaurus cars with psychedelic prints on the side. This is actually pretty cool. I like this. And you know what? If people are into it, whoa, geez. Okay, this isn't working. We're gonna make this work. Pick up some short works of fiction and you might find some interesting things hidden inside. Whoops. You never know, people. This is old, old, old. You people don't even know. Anyway, everybody, I hope you have a very, very Merry Christmas. Last minute gift ideas, people. Let's see if I can get this to stay in here without it falling. Ha ha! I have to credit my friend Big D for this following line, everybody. If you have made it this far into the video, that means you love great content. She came up with that line, I stole it. Hold your head up high, never look down the ground, people. Have a very, very Merry Christmas. I will be back tomorrow morning with a new Christmas beer review. Hopefully all of you will tune in for that. If not, that's okay. Have a happy holidays, all that good stuff, people. Anyway, you know what? Cut the camera. I'm done. See ya!